Yes, we have a dance ministry here. Yes, our pastor lets us do what we need to do to glorify the Lord, as long as it's respectful and decent. And our young people need to know that they can praise the Lord their way. It is about encouraging them to love Jesus and encouraging them to share his word with somebody else, if it be through dance, which it is today. So, when you hear this song, work it out. When the enemy attacks, they gonna work it out. They gonna listen to the words as they move, because their words say something. So I present to you for the first time. Wow, I present to you.
Where's he at?
Alright, y'all, make us proud. It's for Jesus.
Water, everybody. Feed
Racine, come on.
Amen, amen. Let's give him another hand, the young people. He said he'll work it out. Amen. He'll work it out. Doesn't matter what it looks like, he'll work it out. Come on, praise the Lord.
Can we give God a hand, praise? How many of us need a makeover? Anybody sometimes feel like throwing in the towel? They don't see where the answer is coming from? And you just left in a state of depression? Well, God can do that.
Oh, yes.
He can make you over again.
Thank you.
again.
Come on.
Still works.
I want to
thank again all of you for joining us. I want to also thank those parents that entrusted their children to us through our dance ministry. And we just appreciate all of those that have decided to join in worship with us today. Amen. And things go differently when you worship. Amen. I'm telling you right now, your money, it goes differently when you worship the Lord with it. Your life goes differently when you worship the Lord with it. Your family goes differently when you seek to worship the Lord through the way that you take care of your family. And I want to tell you today that those of you that have decided to come out today just to hear word from the Lord, this might be the first time this year, this might be the first time in a few years, but your life trajectory is about to change.
Amen.
Just because of your decision to worship the Lord. And I don't mean jumping up and down and, you know, having your wig fall off and kicking your shoes and falling out your shoes and all that kind of stuff. But I just mean hearing a word from the Lord and being in the presence of the Lord and the Lord's people.
Yes.
Amen. It will make a difference.
Yes.
In your life. Amen?
Yes, amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Anybody ready for a word?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Somebody saying, come on, hurry up, preacher. I got to go. But I just want to direct your attention back to that portion of scripture that was read a little bit earlier. It's going to lead us into our lesson for today. Is that all right?
It's all right.
Amen. Amen. Matthew, the 28th chapter. Verses 10 through 15. Amen.
Amen.
Matthew, the 28th chapter. And I'm just going to lift up verses 10 through 15. Amen.
Amen.
And it reads on this wise. And Jesus said to them,
all right.
Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brethren to go to Galilee, and there they will see me.
Right.
Now while they were going, behold, some of the guard came into the city and reported to the chief priests all the things that had happened. In other words, they told the truthful story. And when they had assembled with the elders and consulted together, they gave a large sum of money to the soldiers, saying, this is what I want you to tell. Tell them his disciples came at night and stole him away while we slept. And if this comes to the governor's ears, he said, I'm going to look out for you. He said, we will appease him and make you secure. So they took the money and did as they were instructed. And this saying is commonly reported among the Jews until this day. Amen?
Right, amen.
Amen. I just want to preach just for a little while today, if y'all would just hang with me for a little while longer from the topic. Get the story straight.
All right.
Get the story straight. Pray with me, if you will. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I ask right now that you continue to dwell in this place in the form of your precious Holy Spirit. Move among thy people and have thine own way. Touch the heart of this waiting congregation that they might receive the words you have given unto your servant. I furthermore request, Lord, that you would take me and hide me behind the shadow of the cross, that they might not see me but Christ in me. Bless somebody's soul. Cleanse and make them whole. In the matchless name of Jesus Christ, I do pray. Amen.
Amen.
And get the story straight. Amen.
Amen.
You know, it's funny today how things have changed. In the past, it seemed like all the news organizations of the day were all on the same page. Am I right?
Right.
I mean, basically, if you read a story in this newspaper, it was, without many exceptions, the same in this newspaper.
All right.
If you watch this news program on TV and it was on Channel 6, if you turn to Channel 3, it may be the same stories being told by a different person, but the stories were basically still the same. Y'all remember that time?
Right, yep.
Well, nowadays, it seems that the news organizations have a difficult time getting the story straight. You can watch CNN, and they will tell you that there's a problem here in the White House, and there's a problem there in the White House, and that the president has lied about this, and the president has lied about that. But then you turn to Fox News, and they'll tell you that he's the greatest president of all time. He's never done anything wrong, and if we build a wall, it's going to solve all of our problems in this country. It seems like we have a hard time getting the story straight, or at least getting the straight story. Am I right about it?
Right.
And it's not just with news organizations, but there are people in your life and mine that always manage to get the facts twisted when it comes time to tell the story. Somebody know what I'm talking about? The same thing happened to you that happened to them, but somehow the story got twisted. And the person that was at fault wasn't at fault anymore. And the person that started it didn't start it anymore. And the one that finished it somehow was wrong. And somehow the story gets all twisted. And it's hard to get the story straight. And I don't care how hard you try, some folk never seem to get the story to come out right. Am I right?
Right.
Those are the kind of people that have a serious problem to sticking to what they know is true. When they describe an event, they just gotta put a little flavor to it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
They gotta pump it up just a little bit more and make it more interesting. Am I right about it?
Amen.
And often they leave out about as much as they add in.
Talk about it now, brother.
And they got a hard time getting the story straight.
Yes, sir.
But when they finish, the little simple thing that happened has turned into a big event. When they finish, the little thing that happened should be on the national news. These people in our lives have a problem keeping the story straight.
Yes, sir.
And while some make mistakes and get the story wrong, there are some folk that I'm convinced deliberately get the story wrong. Y'all don't understand what I'm talking about. There's some folks in our lives that are always lying about something. And you know what I don't like about some folk? Some folk nowadays just lie for no reason whatsoever. Am I right about it? They don't have any reason. They're not trying to keep themselves out of trouble. They're not trying to save their children. They're not trying to keep from going to jail. They just lie for no reason whatsoever. Amen?
Amen.
And when they begin to tell a story, you've gotten so used to them that your mouth starts to curl up on the side because you know they're getting ready to tell another lie. Well, I want to let you know today that in our personal lives, Satan does the same thing. He mounts this, what you might call a massive misinformation campaign on your life. And his job is to basically lower your self-esteem and kill your spirit and dampen your enthusiasm for life and just thwart every effort in your personal life to achieve anything. That's his job. And he begins with us personally, and then he goes to our friends and our associates and our family members to get them to back it up. And the end result is you believe what you hear from him. When that happens, he succeeded in sidetracking you again, pushing you off your path. Some of us have had Satan tell us lies before. Some of us have had Satan tell us, don't worry about it, everybody else got addicted, but you won't. Some of us have had trouble with Satan telling us stories like, don't worry about it, I know he sleeps around, but you're the one. He will never do that with you. I know some of y'all, Satan has told you lies about the women in your life, and it doesn't matter. She busted out his car windows, but she would never do that. Y'all don't hear what I'm talking about today. It's hard to get the story straight. And the end result, you begin to believe what he's telling you. And when that happens, he succeeded in your life. Well, at Easter time, it's important that we all get the story straight.
Yes, sir.
Amen?
All right.
It's important to make sure that everybody knows what the Easter celebration is all about.
Amen.
I read about some young children. They were in the Sunday school, and the Sunday school teacher asked them, "Does anybody know what tomorrow is?" Little girl raised her hand, and she said, "Tomorrow is Good Friday." Very good. She said, "You know what comes after that?" She raised her hand again. She said, "Easter comes after that." Oh, that's very good. Do you know why we celebrate Easter? Yes, because Jesus came out of the tomb. And before she said, "That's very good," the little girl went on and said, "And if he sees his shadow, we're going to have 7 more weeks of winter." Sometimes it's hard to get the story straight when it comes to Easter because we've added so many things. We've embellished so many things about Easter. But see, I know Easter is a celebration that has nothing to do with bunny rabbits.
Right.
Even though you might have colored some eggs last night, it has nothing to do with colored eggs. And even though those eggs and the bunny rabbits are great symbols of fertility and success in the time to come, which is what they represent, they don't have anything to do with the true Easter story. The true Easter stories have nothing to do with new clothes and Easter parades, even though those new clothes represents the newness and the freshness of springtime.
Amen.
The real story of Easter is about Jesus.
Amen.
It's about his death, his burial, and his resurrection, and that's it.
Yes. Amen.
And all those things that they've concocted, all those stories that they have put into play to get you to spend some money, and to buy some new shoes, and to buy this, and to buy that, it's up to you to get the story straight.
Amen.
And it's important to get the story straight because when we look at the Bible here, we see a time when the story started to get distorted.
Yes.
The guards that had guarded the tomb of Jesus, he had been resurrected even though they had placed a stone in front of it and sealed it and put the Roman seal on top of that so nobody would bother it. It seems that Jesus has still risen from the dead. And when the soldiers went back and they started to tell the true story, some folk got a little upset. They said, "Look, we don't want you to tell that story. Because see, if you tell that story, then all these folk that have been believing in him are going to grow. So this is what we're going to do. I'm going to give you some money. And I want you to tell this story. I'm going to pad your pockets and I want you to tell this story. I want you to tell him that his disciples came and carried him away by night." But that was a problem for the soldiers and they didn't realize it. Because if they carried his body away and they were the ones guarding it, then something was wrong. Am I right about
it? All right.
And see, that's something that's very unique about lies and mistruths. They don't stand up to scrutiny. Did y'all hear me? All the lies that you hear on television about what's going on here and what's going on there, you know, it's a shame that we have to go on the internet to verify what the president is saying. Y'all don't hear what I'm talking about today. And you have to go there and they actually have it listed how many lies and mistruths have been told. These soldiers went through the same thing. See, if they said that his disciples stole him away, they were supposed to be guarding it. What excuse are they gonna have? That they were asleep? Well, if they were asleep, then the penalty for them being asleep is that they would be executed. So we can't tell that story. And then if their disciples carried him away and they weren't asleep, then they let them carry him away. And if they let them carry him away, then that's dereliction. No, they can't tell that story. So they were going to tell their story, and the lies and the mistruths were so pervasive that the actual leadership said, "No, you go ahead and tell your lie, and then I'm going to go to your boss and I'm going to back you up. He said, I'm going to take care of you, make sure nothing goes wrong. Amen? Even though the story was riddled with untruths and impossibilities, they went ahead and told their story. And the account shows that the story was completely false. And you must not charge such things to the weakness of understanding, but to the weakness of the heart. God left them to expose themselves. And that's what's going to happen to you when you get the lie. Pretty soon your lie is going to expose. Is anybody here ever lied before? You get,
yeah, right, okay, nobody, yeah, all right. Yeah.
Pretty soon your lie will expose itself. Am I right?
Right.
But they took bribes. And a lot of time money will shut folk up to a lie. Amen? Man, I used to pay folk to keep their mouth shut. Give her a dollar, boy. Don't tell nobody what you saw. Now get on out of here. Amen?
Get on out of here.
The scribes and the Pharisees wanted the story told, but they didn't want it told straight. What they tried to hide was witnessed by a host of individuals, so it couldn't be concealed. And you know, that's the funny thing about now. You know, everybody in here, just about, I would say 99.9% of the people in here are carrying a video camera around with them right now. Got it right in your pocket. Amen. So when something happens in front of your face, you can turn that video camera on, and all those lies that they used to get over with, oh yeah, he reached for a gun, but we see him standing there without even moving his hand. Oh, he was running toward you, but we see him running away from you and you're shooting him in the back. All those lies that they've told over all those years, now we can get the story straight. Because somebody's got a video camera.
All right.
Amen?
Amen.
And don't get me wrong, cops don't like you having those video cameras. Don't let them see you with their phone out. Amen. They might just come after you. But that's a way of keeping the story straight. But so, despite the lies that were told by the soldiers about the resurrection, the story has been told straight. And the world now knows that Jesus Christ was raised from the dead. And he is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Yes.
You know, we got some twisted stories. Today, there's so many people frustrated because we've been the victim of twisted stories. People told stories on you, told lies on you. Folk would tell lies to try and get you in order that they could take your place. Y'all don't hear what I'm talking about today. But folk will tell a lie on you to your woman, so they can take your place. Amen? Folk will tell lies on you to your man, so they can, don't nobody know what I'm talking about today. So they can take your place. Folk will lie on you at the job so they can take your place. Am I right? Folk will lie. And whatever the reason that people tell these stories, they've met the effect of destroying your morale and destroying your optimism. Most of us see how twisted stories can destroy things.
Yes.
How twisted stories can change things. If it wasn't for lies and misconception, we wouldn't be in the political position that we're in now. There were some lies told. And some folk had to go to jail. You know, if it wasn't for lies, some folk wouldn't be in college right now.
Talk about it.
Y'all don't hear what I'm talking about today. And you worked your butt off and worked for your scholarship and worked to pass the SATs with a high score and worked to gather the money and all that type of thing. And then some other folk just lied and paid their way.
Yes, talk about it.
Y'all don't hear what I'm talking about today. But they have the effect of destroying somebody else's hope. Because when lies come out, somebody is always hurt. Somebody's faith is always shaken.
somebody's hope is always deflated when lies come out. See, there's some lies that Satan has been telling you for a while now. Amen?
Amen.
Because if you're in trouble, Satan will lie to you and tell you that God has forsaken you. Amen?
Right. Come on now.
And you know, every now and then all of us experience some difficulties. Am I right?
Yeah.
I mean, things get, you know, things get a little slim, money get a little tight, or whatever the case may be, and you start to experience some difficulties in your life. And every time you have a problem, Satan tries to tell you a story.
Go ahead now.
The truth of the matter is that at the moment, you're just going through some difficult times, but he's going to tell you that it's not just a setback, but this is the way it's going to be.
Amen.
You ain't going to never get it right.
Go ahead.
You're going to lose everything you have. Yeah, he died on you. He left you, and it's never going to be right again. She left you, and you're never going to make it. He tells you these stories, but Satan has taken the facts and twisted them to tell you that God has forsaken you. And in your moment of weakness, he whispers in your ear that it's over. It's over for you. You'll never make your way back. You'll never get out of this thing. You just failed. It's over. Why don't you just give up? But you need to get the story straight. It might be true that you're going through a slump. It might be true that you got a pink slip. It might be true that somebody you thought loved you walked out on you, but I'm telling you, you've got somebody on your side, and he said, "Lo, I'll be with you even unto the ends of the earth. You're never alone." No matter what kind of story Satan tells you. And then every now and then when you get weak, Satan will tell you the story that you never going to be strong again. You're going through some problems. The doctor has given you a certain prognosis. And folk, Satan will send folk in your life that will tell you you're never going to be right again.
All right.
Or you're never going to get out of that. The doctor said he got diabetes. You'll never get out of that. The doctor said that he's got cancer. You'll never come back from that. Amen? And he wants to sow frustration and doubt in your life. And because you're human, you get weak.
Talk about it.
I get weak every now and then.
Yes, sir.
And no. Jesus had a period in his life. He was out in the wilderness. Mm-hmm. And he was hungry. He had been out there for 40 days without food and without water. And the devil came back with a tray of bread and some nice lemonade. And told him, y'all didn't hear that story?
Talk about it now.
Told him, why don't you eat up? Turn these stones into bread.
Yes.
Jesus said, get thee behind me, Satan.
Uh-huh.
Stop what you're trying to do. I'm telling you that you've been told that your life is never going to get back. You're never going to get back in your life where you were. That you're never going to come up. That you're going to continue to lose. But I came here today to remind you to get the story straight.
All right now.
It is true that you're going to experience some weakness in your life. Every now and then you're going to cry. Every now and then you're going to get sad. But the word of God declares that they that wait upon the Lord, you're going to renew your strength. You're going to mount up on wings as eagles. You're going to run and not get weary. You're going to walk and you're not going to faint. It's not going to be this way all the time. It's not going to be this hard all the time. It's not going to be the way it is right now, no matter what Satan tells you. And then you know what? The number one thing that Satan is trying to tell you today, those of you that are not saved, he's trying to tell you, you'll never be saved.
Yeah, yeah.
You'll never get salvation. You've done too much. You drank too much. You smoked too much.
Go ahead now.
You slept around too much.
Come on now.
You said some things out of your mouth that you shouldn't have. You didn't do the things that you should have. And you'll never get salvation. Well, that's a twisted story. A person who is outside the ark of safety for a long time is going to be told that you're lost for good. Don't worry about it. You might as well eat, drink, and be merry. For tomorrow you're going to die. Don't even worry about it. Amen?
Amen.
Somebody might have told you, hey, I'm not worried about it. I'm
I'm not worried about going to hell. All my friends going to be there anyway. Amen. Drunkards and the gamblers and the thieves and the adulterers. Satan is trying to convince you that you've destroyed your life and you'll never get it back. Well, you only have to look at a woman that Jesus found by a well.
All right, come on now.
She thought it was over for her.
All right.
Ashamed to come during the daylight hours.
Go ahead, man.
But she met Jesus at the well. And don't get me wrong, her life was messed up. She had several husbands, and the one that she was sleeping with now wasn't even hers. But to get the story straight, you got to look at what happened after she met Jesus. And she ran through the town saying, come see a man that told me everything I've ever done. She got her life back together, even though Satan had her so ashamed that she wouldn't even come to the well during the daylight. If any person believes in Christ, Romans 10 and 9 told me, you shall be saved.
Amen.
No matter what you've been through, no matter where you've been, no matter what house you came out of, no matter where you came from last night, if you believe in Jesus, you shall be saved. But you know what? I know y'all got some Easter egg hunts and somebody got a Easter ham.
Yes.
Some of the non-pork folk gonna get mad at me. Some folk got an Easter turkey, and I know you got to get to it, so I won't hold you much longer. But I just want you to think about the fact that no matter how Satan tries to turn things around, you've got to help the world get the story straight. There's somebody in here to think that Jesus came save them, that Jesus can't save their life because they all messed up. I wish I had somebody that used to be on the street corner looking for drugs that'll tell somebody and get the story straight. I wish I had somebody that used to fall off the bar stool because you got drunk every single night. I wish they would tell somebody and get the story straight. The disciples were completely discouraged by the crucifixion. They hid themselves with criminals and they stayed away from the public view. But when they heard the word, they got revived and they got rejuvenated.
Yes, sir.
When we get the story straight, we make sure that the world knows the true story about what happened on resurrection morning. It's not about Easter bunnies, because Easter bunnies can't raise bowed down heads. You gotta get the story straight. It's not about colored eggs, because colored eggs can't wipe the tears from your eyes. You gotta get the story straight. It's not about brand new clothes, because brand new clothes can make you look good on the outside, but they can't save your soul on the inside. You gotta get the story straight. It's important to get the story straight, because Satan can make you feel like you're on the losing side. It's not ever gonna get right. I'm not ever gonna get my head right. I'm not ever gonna get my heart right. I'm not ever gonna get my money right. But when you get the story straight, you understand that you serve a God that has guaranteed that you're gonna be on the winning side. Can't you hear Paul saying, nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors. Somebody saw you going through a hard time the other day, and as the tears fell from your eyes, you better tell them to wait a minute. I might be crying now, but you gotta get the story straight. Weeping may endure for a night, but you're coming in the morning. Somebody saw you the other day wrestling with your troubles and problems. Tell them to wait a minute before they go out there gossiping about you. Because Paul said, for in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in the secret of his tabernacle. Shall he hide me? That's no wonder I heard a songwriter trying to get the story straight. He said, I'm so glad Jesus lifted me. I'm so glad trouble don't last always. Somebody saw enemies surrounding, talking behind your back, stabbing you in your side. But David said, sit there at my right hand until I make your enemies your footstool. When you get the story straight, a funny thing happens. When you get the story straight, you can tell folk that I serve a God that turned my misfortunes into opportunities. When you get the story straight, you can tell somebody I serve a God that turned my minutes of pain into years of ecstasy. When you get the story straight, you can tell somebody that I serve a God that turned my day of agony into years of ecstasy. When you get the story straight, you can tell somebody I serve a God that turned weeping eyes into warm smiles. When you get the story straight, you tell somebody I serve a God that turned my sadness into gladness. When you get the story straight, you can tell somebody I serve a God that turned my setbacks into setups. When you tell the story, you've got to make sure that you get it straight. You got to tell the world that 2,000 years ago, on a hill called Calvary, the Lamb of God lost his life. But when you get the story straight, you tell them he carried that cross and died on that cross. But even before somebody get the story wrong, they start running through the city saying, you know what? Jesus saved himself and saved others, but he can't save himself. They didn't get the story straight. If they waited just a little while, they would have seen him die. If they waited just a little while, they would have seen him buried. If they waited just a little while, they would have seen him roll the stone away. If they would have waited, they could get the story straight. But early Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hand. There's somebody that already pronounced your destiny. There's somebody that already said you'll never get it back together. There's somebody that's already saying you'll never get your money right. There's somebody that's already saying that you'll never be happy again. Well, I want you to go out and tell them to get the story straight, because Jesus got up. I can get up because Jesus is a healer. I can be healed because Jesus is a way maker. I can make a way out of no way. Get the story straight. As long as I got King Jesus, everything is gonna be alright. Ain't he alright? Ain't God alright? I got my story straight. He saved my soul. Ain't he alright? No matter what they try to say about you, if you got Jesus on your side, you're going to come out a winner. You're going to come out on top. You're going to get through this thing. You're going to get your healing. You're going to get your deliverance. As long as you got Jesus, get the story straight. I'm all right. I'm all right. Get the story straight. It ain't going to be like this always. Get the story straight. These tears, they ain't gonna run down my face always. I'm not gonna be tired. I'm not gonna be sick. I'm not gonna be frustrated. You can talk about me all you want, but you better get the story straight. I got a Savior who's able to do exceedingly and abundantly beyond all I can ask or even think. Before you start talking about my situation, you better get the story straight.
Whoa, thank you, Father.
I know the Lord what that means is somebody has an opportunity to change their story. I know the direction the story's been going in, but it's time to get the story straight. Jesus can still save you. Jesus can still deliver you. Jesus can still turn your life around. I know what everybody's been saying, but you can't believe all that. It's time to get the story straight. If you want to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, if you want to have your life turned in a new direction, taking a new trajectory, this is your opportunity right now. Why don't you just come forward and give me your hand and give Jesus your heart. Would there be one that wants to accept the Lord right now? You can turn things around. Hallelujah. Would there be one? Come on, one more. I know you want to change. I know you want things to be different. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
Listen, I want to call all the dancers up, all the ones that are still here. Y'all come on up. Y'all come on up. I want y'all to take another bow. Amen. Amen. Come on up, y'all. Come on up, y'all. We want y'all to take one more bow. All the dancers, come on up. Amen. Teresa, you going to introduce everybody for me that's left? Amen. 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 Let's come on up, y'all. Come on up.
Come on, y'all. Come don't on be up. Scared.
Come on up. We just want to thank you for all that you've done. Amen. Thank you for being a part of this ministry. Anybody else? That's it?
Yeah.
Oh, three people left. Okay, well, introduce the ones that you have here.
Okay, so we have Jalen.
Hi, Jalen.
Come on. Take a bow.
Great job.
We have LaShawn.
All right, LaShawn. Amen.
Step up. Take a bow. We have Yazani.
Oh, Yazani.
Yazani, who's no stranger to our church. And we had Brother Andre, who's not here.
Andre.
We had LaShawna, who's not here. And we had Anairi, who's not here.
Amen.
And I was downstairs, and I got two new members that said they want to join.
Amen.
So that's exciting.
You gotta introduce yourself.
And I'm Latrice.
Amen.
I'm the director and the teacher. We have classes every Tuesdays and Thursdays. It's free, it's fun, it's hip-hop, and I hope that some of you guys will join. Thank you.
Amen.